This is one of the most powerful tools at the doctor's disposal when diagnosing and treating cancer. I'm talking about the PET CT scan. So what's a PET CT? The PET CT stands for positron emission tomography / computed tomography. A couple of big words, but we'll get into that as well. It's a combination of two different types of scans that combined give the doctor a good detailed picture of what's going on inside the body. So why combine the two scans? Well, the PET scan by itself cannot reliably resolve a point source smaller than 4 to 5 millimeters. At least that's what's advertised, but closer to 10 millimeters in practice. And however, the CT scan can easily resolve points down to less than 1 millimeter in size. So why not just use the CT? Well, let's get into that. If you're finding these videos helpful, leave us a comment down below. Let us know what you think. Ask any questions. We'd love to hear from you. So the PET part of the scan uses a special type of radioactive tracer, and it is put into a glucose solution that's then injected into the body. And the glucose is easily absorbed by the cancer cells. Remember, cancer is a metabolic disease. So what it's doing is it takes that glucose and starts sucking it in to give it more energy and make it more active. Since cancer cells are so much more active, they're the first ones to absorb the glucose. And the glucose with the radioactive marker is then easy for the PET scanner to pick up. The tracers will emit the positrons, and which are the tiny particles that are then detected by the scanner. As the tracer moves through your body, it collects in areas where there's a lot of activity, such as around the cancer cells. Now, this is an image of my PET scan showing the tonsil and lymph node tumors in my neck in June of 2021. The two dark spots on the left side are the accumulation of the radioactive tracer in the tumor. This is looking face on. And on this next image, this is looking from my left and into my neck and head. And again, you're seeing the big black blobs. These are the three points of the cancer. One in the tonsil and two lymph nodes, all in the lymph side. So now we know where the cancer is. We just have to be able to dial it down to exactly how big it is and exactly where it is. So now we do a CT or the computed tomography scan, and that uses really powerful x-rays to create a detailed image of the inside of your body. So here's a CT scan of my head and neck. You'll notice there's no glowing blob of energy. You'll see a much more clear outline of my skeletal system and the internal organs of my body. So you don't see the big blob, so you don't really know where the cancer is. You could detect cancer this way, but it takes a lot of training, years of practice, to be able to accurately determine if what you're seeing is actually cancer or not. So now what we have to do is we have to combine these two. So we'll combine these two types of scans so doctors can see exactly where the tracer has collected in the CT scan as well and what it's collecting around. So here is my PET CT scan. As you can see, by putting these together or fusing the images, the doctors would get a much clearer picture of the location and size of the tumors. This is critical for the detection, treatment, and post-treatment evaluation of cancer cells. That's why the PET CT is such a powerful weapon in fighting cancer. Till next time, see ya.